Hi, welcome to this video from Techcanvass. Today, we are going to discuss about how should you go about preparing for the ECBA certification. So let's get started. Techcanvass is an IABA and ISQI Germany training partner. And through them, we offer business analysis, agile business analysis, and other courses. First of all, let's see what is ECBA. ECBA is an entry certificate for business analysts. This is offered by International Institute of Business Analysis, Canada. This certification is meant for professionals who wish to start their career as a business analyst or who want to learn formal skills of business analysis. There is no specific experience criteria required to be eligible for the ECBA certification, but you need to get 21 hours of professional development hours as advised by IABA. This includes attending a training program from an endorsed education provider like Techcanvass. This exam is based on Business Analysis Body of Knowledge, the book which is given by IABA to its members. So when you apply for the certification exam, you will get this book and you can prepare for the exam using this book and the training program which you're going to attend. So what kind of an exam is this? This is a multiple choice question exam. There will be 50 questions to be completed in 1 hour. So from a timing perspective, you have sufficient time. And good thing is there's no negative marking. Another important thing about this exam is that you can take it from home. Now, there are multiple chapters in the book which is provided by IABA, and every chapter has a defined percentage in terms of number of questions. Okay, so some of the chapters, as you can see, have very high weightage and some others have low weightage. So you can even prioritize your preparation. We will look at this aspect when we are discussing the strategy and these steps. What kind of questions would you expect in the exam? The exam comprises of questions which are not memory based. So it's not a test of your memory. You don't need to remember and memorize the definitions. So that is out of the way. The most importantly, the exam is based on concepts understanding. So when you are reading BABOK, you need to understand the concepts. You don't need to even remember the key terms which are used frequently in the BABOK guide, because in the exam, the focus is not to test again whether you have captured the typical term in the BABOK or remembering the definition of it. Rather, they try and even give you synonyms of those key terms just to check whether you have the good understanding of the concepts or not. And it's primarily about how business analysis activities take place. Because you are not experienced, so there will be no questions based on the experience or the application of business analysis knowledge. So look at this question, and this will give you a fair bit of idea that the questions are going to be based on simple understanding of the concepts. Here, instead of asking what is priority, they are asking the question in a different manner, explaining you the concept of priority and then asking you to relate to the term priority. So it's all about understanding. Again, the next question is about the role of the stakeholders. And if you look at the role of the stakeholder in BABOK, it has been repeated in multiple places that one of the role of stakeholders is to understand and know who is the signing off authority in the customer organization. Again, the next question again is about why do we look at the assumptions. Now, these questions are not very complex, as you can imagine. And by looking at it, these are not very complex questions. Neither they expect you to understand the application of the business analysis concepts. So if you are careful enough to read and understand the topics well, you would be able to clear it very, very easily. So based on our experience and the success of our students, we have devised a strategy to prepare and complete the certification in 6 to 7 weeks, depending on how busy you are with your day-to-day activities. For that, we need to have certain steps for you to follow. The first thing is get the BABOK book as soon as possible, because that is the reference book and it's important that you get it as soon as possible. So a good time to start it is when you're starting the course. Become a member and you'll get the BABOK. Next, you need to start reading BABOK along with the course as it is going. Every course, like in Techcanvass's course, we cover BABOK chapters as well. So as you start covering the BABOK chapter in the training program, you also start reading it. Please note that BABOK is not like a textbook or a novel which you can finish in 5 days. It's a book which requires a lot of patience to go through. So consistency is important. Every day, try and read BABOK for an hour, for 2 hours, as much as possible for you, so that you make it a habit. And as you start going through the chapters, keep an eye on the weightages provided in the table earlier in this slide. There are some chapters which have a weightage as high as 20% or 24%. Obviously, those chapters become very important for you. So if we consider 3 of the knowledge area chapters, they are 64% for the entire exam. That means out of the 50 questions, you're going to get 32 questions from 3 chapters. I'm sure everyone might have done the same kind of studying during your university exams, because I have done it. And I know if you can prioritize the chapters, it takes less time and you can focus more on individual chapters. So take that approach, which is what we suggest, so that your total time to grasp BABOK reduces. Now, as you're going through the chapter, you can start taking the knowledge-wise or chapter-wise tests. So our question bank has chapter-wise tests as well. So start going through those chapter-wise tests on a regular basis as you are going through the chapters. Target should be 70%. In each chapter, you should get 70%. So if you start getting 70% score regularly, that means you should feel confident about that chapter understanding and you can move on to the next step. After you finish the chapter-wise test, you can start taking full-length tests. Full-length tests have 50 questions with 1 hour time frame. That's the real simulated test. Now, there are multiple tests available in your question bank. You start taking these tests, and as you take 1 or 2 tests, you'll start feeling confident. If you're getting 70% or above score, that's the time when you start looking to book the exam date. Because typically you should keep in mind that you will not get the exam date or exam time in a week, for a week's time. It takes a little more than a week's time. So advance booking of the exam date and time is important. 2 to 3 weeks should be a very safe bet. That's the time you're taking the full length test, and that's the time when you book. So depending on your confidence level, you book it 10 days ahead or 15 days ahead, or maybe a little more, but don't delay it by more than 3 weeks. So your target in all the full length tests should also be 70%. And once you start getting it, that means your preparation is absolutely at its peak. If you're not getting it, mark the areas which are weak. In the exam simulation bank, when you take a test, you can do the analysis of each of the tests. And you can go back and test, check each question which was wrong and see why you got it wrong. Go back and revise those points and then come back and take the test again. There is no limit in the number of times you can take the full length test or even the chapter wise test. The the portal has a reporting dashboard, which also shows you all the reports, all the tests where you have scored less than 70%, all the tests which you have taken either chapter wise or full length, so that you can do a full analysis of your performance. Now, if you're getting the 70% score regularly in full length tests, that means you are ready. And now, if you have made some notes, it's time to revise. Or if you have whatever mechanism you have used to have short notes, go back and revise them. And at this point, I feel you should be spending around 6 to 7 weeks in reaching that stage. So once you finish step number 8, you should be close to your exam date. Go back and revise your notes, and good luck from our side. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any questions, you can always write to us.